You're watching WMAR 2 News.
I'm Christian Schaefer with your WMAR 2 News update. The coronavirus continues to spread rapidly in Maryland right now. This morning, the state health department reported that there's 1,338 new cases. So this is the seventh straight day that more than 1,000 cases of COVID-19 have been added to the state's total. The rate of coronavirus tests coming back positive rose again as well, from 5.05% Monday to 5.24% today. 12 more people have died, bringing the state's death toll since the start of the pandemic to 4,084, and 54 more people have had to be hospitalized just in this morning's report. Now, Governor Larry Hogan's called a news conference for tonight. His news release does not specify exactly what the governor plans to address, only that he will be talking about, quote, the state's efforts to slow the spread of COVID-19. That will be at 5 o'clock tonight from the State House. You can watch it here on WMAR 2 News. And one of the things the governor could talk about is a new way for people to find out whether they've been exposed to someone with COVID-19. This morning, the state health department launched a new app for Apple and Android phones called MD COVID Alert. It uses Bluetooth to notify you that you may have been close to someone who's tested positive. iPhone or Android users may have gotten a push notification asking whether they want to start getting what the state calls exposure notification alerts. Health officials say if you do choose to enable MD COVID Alert on your phone, you will remain anonymous, your location is never tracked, and no data is collected. They also say the app is not a substitute for traditional contact tracing.
And now from WMAR 2 News, Maryland's most accurate forecast.
Happy Tuesday, everyone. Today is our last dry day as high pressure moves offshore, but we are going to see a little bit more cloud cover than we did yesterday. But high temperatures still make it back well above normal. We're talking low to mid 70s as we head into the later parts of the afternoon. But a cold front will be charging across the state Wednesday into Thursday. That's going to bring moderate to heavier rainfall, possibly dealing with anywhere from 1 to upwards of 3 inches when it's all said and done. So isolated flash flooding is certainly possible, so definitely keep an eye on that. Heading into Thursday, though, that's when we're going to start to see that rain taper off, especially during the afternoon. Drier as we round out the work week with cooler temperatures, looking more seasonal, though, around the mid and upper 50s as we head into the upcoming weekend.
Okay, Stevie, thanks very much, and stay with us online at WMAR2news.com all day long for updates on top stories and breaking news. For news and weather on the go, you can download the WMAR2 News app. It's in the App Store. It's got live radar, and you can set up breaking news alerts to come straight to your phone or tablet. Thanks for watching. I'm Christian Schaefer.
This WMAR2 News update is sponsored by Jones Junction.